Hello guys, this is Heflamok again. We are still on the DreamHack. It's Saturday, the second day, which means we already entered, well, we entered the hot phase of the Hearthstone tournament. Like, all the groups have been played out. Round one is almost through, I think. The last results are just flying in. Round two will be tomorrow, as well as in all the finals. Lothar was here, and of course, thanks to him, we also got Thijs. And now Thijs, say hello.
Hello everyone.
We have, of course, also some questions prepared for him. So, again, shout out to Nitra for preparing him. So, Thijs, before Nihilum, of course, you were in another team, MYM, namely. Tell us a bit about how was there, and especially how the exit was for you. I mean, everybody knows it was not the most pleasant story. So, share a bit of your impressions there.
Yeah, at the start, like, I'm still really happy what MIM did for me. It was the start I needed. I needed to go into like a pro team, and they did a lot for me. But at the end, like, we had some issues. We couldn't really work really together anymore. So that was like a moment where I just had to decide. Even MIM didn't really agree that I just didn't want to play for them anymore. That was the most important.
So the exit wasn't the easy thing, but once you established that by any means necessary, you had like a phase between MYM and Nihilum, because Nihilum actually came later than your exit of MYM. What did you do? What did you think in that period? Did you look out to other teams, or were there already talks with Nihilum? Hey, there's going to be a project in the future, and would you be part of it?
Yeah, I had, after I left MIM, I was already like, I was pretty sure that I will probably find a good team that was fitting me. It doesn't really matter like how big it was. And yeah, I had some, like, after I left, I had a lot of conversations going on. And at the end, like, I had some really good teams I could join, but I was really happy with what Nihilum could do for me, what their plan was and everything.
And talking about Nihilum, I mean, you have some previous experience, we already said it, with MYM. Now that you're in Nihilum, what's your standard day? Did it change somehow? Did it get more intense, more competitive? Just walk the viewers and myself, obviously, through a day of ties in Nihilum. What is your day like?
Yeah, like, I'm really happy that I'm now in Nihilum. Like, I have the feeling that even if you are a player and you are maybe... That you get heard, that they listen to you, that they understand your situation sometimes, and like that's really important for me. It's not only about like a really good contract, but also just how you communicate with each other and everything, and that's really good in Nihilum. And yeah, just in general, we have a really awesome team. We fit each other really well. We talk a lot with each other. We're having fun with each other. It's just it's really cool.
And how is the structure? Is there actually like a strict schedule you have to stick to? I mean, strict is maybe too strict in words, but is there actually like a call from the management that says, guys, around this time, I think we should sit together, talk about maybe previous analysis or what's to come, or practice hours, something like that? Like, is there really a day schedule for you?
There is not really a day schedule. Like, before tournaments, we really practice together. Like. Even if it's not like not needed from the management or something, we still want to do it. We do it, and we are probably one of the teams that practice like the hardest together. But we still like how a day looks for me. Like I'm still streaming a lot. Like I enjoy streaming. Everyone in our team enjoys streaming, and we all do it a lot. And yeah, but like for the tournaments, like for this DreamHack, for all the big tournaments, every LAN at least, we're really practicing together. And normally it looks like that we just play, we stream in the morning, and then if there is like a really tournament coming up, we really want a call in the evening, practice together. If there is no tournament coming up, we take it a bit more relaxed sometimes. But when we know we are going to a tournament, we want to be prepared.
So everything intensifies just the closer a tournament gets. But is it like this, you remember from school, like tomorrow there's an exam, so I study the night? Or is it like, how early do you actually start to prepare for a tournament?
Normally we do it like, we really want to talk already like a week before. And I think that like the last 3 days, like we have a call or we have like a call in the evening together. We practice, like, it depends like how much time. Like there is always... Everyone has sometimes time schedules, or it's like an evening away, but we really try to just fit it. We don't have like really times you have to be there. We just always try to fit in the time. But like, as I said, the last 3 days, we really want to just have a call in the evening and test our lineups.
Talking about the team, I mean, it's you, Rado, and especially Life Coach. Life Coach is sort of the player with the most value to his name in Nihilum, I'd say. And he's also someone you can take a lot of experience from because he has a lot of experience. He wasn't the biggest competitor in 2014, but is his experience, especially when we talk about preparation for tournaments, something you and Rado learn from? Do you really sit down together and listen to him, what he has to say?
Especially like we learn a lot from just like not maybe the experience in the game himself, but we learn a lot from his like experience of life, or at least I do. I can't speak for others, but like how he's just combining everything, and I also learn a lot from his strategies, and he's probably maybe learning a bit from us too. But I'm really learning a lot from like how he combines everything, how his lifestyle is, and how he's just able to always take it on a high note, his playstyle.
So it's just sharing information with each other, and everybody is taking something pretty much. Anyway, talking about DreamHack, not just this one, also the last one. It was a highlight in your career. And given the fact that you won, is there any change to you? Did anything change after you took that trophy? Attention-wise, more pressure on you? Because once you have success, then everybody expects you to have even more success, or at least repeatedly good numbers, good results and everything. Did anything change after the last success here on the DreamHack?
I wouldn't say that like something like extremely changed, but for me it was really important. Like I had a lot of good results, taking like good results like top four, top eight, really a lot, and I qualified a lot from open tournaments at that stage. So for me, that win, it meant a lot. Like it was really something I wanted, that I just want to win one tournament at least. And I agree with that it gives some pressure, but like I can actually handle that pretty okay. When I'm playing the game, I play the game. Before I feel a bit pressured and I want to go with the best lineups I can. And I'm one of the person that really wants to practice a lot, but it's fine. The pressure is for me fine.
So because that pretty much leads to Nitra's next question. He said, yes, your results are like bottom line always decent, but you're less dominant, he says, in overall. And he was curious if the current expansion, and we talk about the expansion that's currently used in the format, so Blackrod is excluded here. Is it yours, or is it just the expansion that is, I don't know, you never really got warm with?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I really had like the biggest change for me, and maybe still the most difficult one, is the Conquest mode. Like it is a good mode, but I really struggle sometimes to find like the really Last Hero Standing. Was like I always was one of the better Last Hero Standing players. I really like the format. I always came with one of the better strategies, and now I really have to, like, it's so dependent on your opponent now sometimes, that I really have to fit in my way, fit in everything. But the Black Ore Mountain, that's really early to say like what's really gonna happen about that, but I'm always excited about new cards at least. And yeah, for just the Conquest mode, like in the last year standing, I felt really that I was one of the better players, and now it's still for me like I'm still having good results, like to for a fire game, and I'm doing pretty okay at events, but I want to get like another win somewhere or in final maybe.
And besides cards and the new little toys we get by Blizzard step by step, there are also other big changes, especially to the tournament landscape. The DreamHack Summer will be in 3 months, and they will actually change the format to a completely non-invite format. So is this something you agree with? Is this the end of an era? That's actually how Nidra phrased it. He really sees it as a big impact thing. What do you think about it? Is it something we should take for all the other tournaments, or will it be this one only tournament and we see other tournaments coming up with the invite? So in a nutshell, what do you think about this approach?
Yeah, for me it depends a bit on what you expect from your tournament. Like if you play in House Cup, you just want to have fun. You want to, like, it has to be funny to watch. Then it makes more sense to invite a lot of players just to make a good tournament, make fun of the tournament. But like if there is like a really competitive tournament like DreamHack, I can really agree with like just making it all open, let the best make your result and qualify for it. Like I am one of the persons that came from playing qualifiers and making a name of themselves. So I'm actually a big fan of it, and I think it's just fair to everyone, and I really like it to see that everything will be open at the next stream. I'm excited for that. I want to qualify.
Okay, so we have Thijs' vote on the new format. We have to see how that pans out, because nobody knows what's coming after. Do other tournaments join? Do we get that format? Talking about another tournament, Amaz's tag team tournament is coming up. You team up with Radu, right? And, Nightwa was sort of curious, like, you both together in one tournament, like, who's taking over the dominant role? Who's going to be captaining it? It's his own curiosity. Tell us something about it, like your synergy with Radu, and who's taking over the lead?
We played, like, so much together, actually. Radu are just, we always, like, we have a call, so we call each other a lot, and we fit each other pretty well. If there is, like, someone that is more dominant, I will say that's Radu. I will say that's not maybe me. But I think that we listen really good to each other, so I think that we just can fit that really well.
So, in Nightwa's words, he has the brains, you the looks. In the end, both will perform well, I hope. Either ways, I guess, thank you for all the answering the question. Thank you for having patience with me as a Hearthstone noob. Shout outs to sponsors, mom, dad, team captain, manager, anything?
Yeah, shout outs to my parents that always support me. Like, my parents supporting me a lot, and they mean a lot for me. Same for my brother. A big shout out to Nihilum, of course. Like, I'm really happy at the team, and I really enjoy my stay here. And yeah, shout out to everyone that's practiced sometimes with me. I also have some practice partners that are not in the team, so shout out to all of them. And yeah, that's it.
Okay, then I want to say thank you, Thijs, for joining us. And of course, I'm glad you found a new home. You can identify with Nihilum, seems to be a decent team, and it's probably full of surprises. We have to see in the next tournaments. There's a lot of new and exciting stuff to come. That's pretty much it. Our second interview here in the Hearthstone area of the DreamHack Bucharest. It was definitely exciting. Thanks again to you. You guys, have loud.